Roma, Roma, ma, gaga, ooh la la, what you about Roma? Okay, step one, trace the outline of the front of your foot where your toes are on the styrofoam with a marker or a pen or something that will be permanently on the styrofoam. You're going to want to leave a little bit of space from where your toes are and the front of the styrofoam just to give it a little bit more room and if you mess up while cutting. Step two, this is the shaping and cutting process of the front platform. And you're just going to want to go straight down from the lines that you drew when you traced your foot. This is just probably the most crucial and important part of the process because it really determines the overall shape and balance of the shoe. And if you mess this up, you can just restart on a different block because there's really no turning back. So you're going to keep cutting until you get the correct shape that you want. And on the back of the platform, you're going to want to angle it downward just because that's the way that the shoe looks. This is optional, but if you want it to look just like the shoe, you can do this. Now also on the sides, you're not going to want them to be very blocky or pointy. So you're going to want to shape those to be more round and circular. And you're going to have all these leftovers that are pretty messy, but you can just throw away. Step three. This part you're going to be using your Mod Podge and your large brush. Now this part, basically you're just going to be covering the entire foam platform with the Mod Podge. This gives it more durability and it makes it more tough and hard so that if you do have any accidents or anything, it will hold your weight, which is good. So this part is pretty important. Step four, you're gonna take your dried Mod Podge platform and you're gonna wrap the entire thing in duct tape. Step five, you're gonna wanna trace an outline of your foot on any cardboard. This is just from an old Vans box that I had lying around. And you're gonna wanna just cut it out and then this is what's gonna be used as the main arch for the shoe. Now, with this piece of cardboard, you're just going to want to angle it until you think that it's the right shape, and you're just going to want to tape it securely to the platform. Step six. This is the actual heel part of the shoe, and what you're going to do is you're just going to want to hot glue this onto the cardboard part until you have it at the right shape. I just took a regular size wooden dowel, and I cut it in half, and you're just going to want to tape this on securely. Step seven. Now you're going to want to take your Mod Podge and your large brush and you're just going to want to do a couple coats of it over the back and just anywhere where you don't think it's very sturdy. Step 8. Now I couldn't really record this process because my camera was really messed up, but basically what you want to do is you're going to want to put your foot in the shoe and you're going to want to tape over your foot. You're just going to want to do this about halfway so that it stays on your foot. Step 9. Cut about 10 strips out of your thin poster board. These will be used for the structure of the rounded part on the front of the shoe. Step 10. Take one of your pieces and tape it to the front of the shoe. Angle it upward because this is what will create the hump in the front of the shoe, the armadillo part. Step 11. This is when you make the front hump of the shoe. I've already done this side for you and I'll model what to do on the other side. Now what I've already done was I've used 4 strips and I've made the hump And all I did this was by taping the strips to each side of the shoe and then putting an arc over. Now, to fill in these gaps, you just simply take a piece of your poster board and just cover it with the duct tape. This part you're going to want to cover with a lot of duct tape. This is just so that it'll make it a lot more sturdy and hard, and just in case that you might have a fall or something might hit it, it won't break as easily. Step 12. Take your remaining poster board strips, and what you're going to want to do is tape them and make a half circle around the heel of the shoe. This will just close it off and hopefully keep the shoe on your foot. Just build this up until about the middle of your ankle and just shape it whichever way you want. To create the shape of the ankle part, you're just going to take your scissors and simply just cut around. The only thing that's left to do is just tape it securely, and you should just try on the shoe and see how it feels. Now all that's left to do is to cut a part for your zipper, glue that on, and apply your fabric. And that's it. Your shoes are done. My shoes took about, I don't even know, my shoes took me at least 2 months to make. That's just because I did not stay focused, I did not have the time, but I got them done. I'm really happy with the way that mine turned out, and they're very nice for people who, I guess, not necessarily don't have enough money, but don't have the tools to cut wood or even the ability to cut wood. I cannot cut wood. I cannot buy wood. I can't do any of that. So I hope this is a very budget-friendly way to make these amazing heels. And I wanted to give a big thank you to the Creature Design. I don't know. Because for the inspiration, he's a very big inspiration to me, and I'm sure he's a big inspiration to many other little monsters. He's taught me a lot through the shoemaking process and other things like that. So a big shout out to him. Go subscribe to him. I'll put his link in the crotch bar below. I love you guys so much, and thank you for subscribing, and make sure you share this video with anyone. I don't even care. Make sure you like and comment, and if you have any questions, just leave a comment below or send me a message, and I'd be gladly to answer. Thank you, and good luck. Love you. Mwah.